No, but I mean, like, you see the news all the time, Northern Ireland, isn't it? And you come and you think, Christ, what a nice place.
Hello? Testing, testing. One? Hello? Testing.
Stopped in Warrington to see friends, and stopped in Liverpool, and oh, we went all over the place.
Oh, right.
Excuse me. Why does that bother it? I've done something here.
Oh, that one is it?
Yeah, it's falling off.
Please drive into Asia.
That's the check we can
And we'll put number 6 on the Mustang for you. I'll
give you a little wrinkle around it.
No, I did realise this.
That's your only man.
So let's hear from you, Fermanagh. Apparently,
From here into it, is that?
Quarter, Robert.
That's fifth, third.
Fifth?
Last night, we started them up, and 8 o'clock started them up with the rev counter, put it to one.
Yeah, yeah, one new bag, then you bring a baggie.
Ready? Is
that the receiver? With the driver of the rev.
Thank you.
you see a beetle. Okay. Look on this way now, mate. Big happy smile. And again.
We want to bring him right.
He'll do it.
Yes. The wind actually, the wind's blowing. Yeah, it was slightly smaller.
Bottom line display. As you arrive, you have received a program, and hopefully that will give you some of the information that you will need. Joined today with the services of our commentator, Mr. Joe Dival, who'll just show his face here. Who is known to flown fly 747s, whatever they are. I don't know what 747s.
Big airplane.
He's also a monitor. And most of the pilots you see here today are also full-size aircraft pilots. So not flying toys normally, these are serious people. Right, without further ado, we'll carry on the display. We were to have the services of the chairman of Fermanagh District Council, but for some reason he's been delayed. And we intend to carry on in his absence, rather than keep you good people waiting. As a stand-in for the chairman, we've got the next best thing. We've got another pamphlet today from the services, and to represent the services, we've got Major Robson, our first Cheshire. So gentlemen and ladies, this day will start with the flight of two fighter aircraft. If you can cast your minds back, those that can, 50 years or more, we're sitting on an airfield somewhere in Europe, and we've two fighter aircraft waiting to be dispersed on the sight of any enemy aircraft flying past. Now normally, you've all seen the films, never seen reality, these were dispersed by firing a very pistol, a flare, and this is what we want to simulate today. So two aircraft are getting ready. I'll pass you over to Mr. Joe Dival, who will give you some commentary from now on the aircraft. And finally, I hope you have an enjoyable day, and thank you for your support. Thank you.
on the Potter Harrington Citizen top line version of a Springland left pass play. This is a nicely man-made for fun. And
The first action was seen by their commanding officer in 1940 when he was attacked by four Italian fighters. One of them was shot down. squadron was then tasked to evacuate Crete in Greece. There followed another detachment to India, where they evacuated over 500 casualties in 30 days. Number 230 squadron saw out the war in Singapore.
Engines of 10 cc's each.
Again.
Told we've got a bit of engine problems. Nothing too serious, we hope.
This aircraft, in spite of its,
shall we say, purpose design, was actually never used in combat. He's going for it, high speed. Those engines sound on song to me. The Mustang had a very comfortable cockpit to see out of it. Nice comfortable chair to sit in. Controls came easily to the hand. Wasn't like Spitfire where you needed three hands to fly it. Wide undercarriage, easy on the control, handles on the ground like a Cadillac, beautiful.
Gentlemen's on wreck. That's our show for us.
This is your table here. Are you going to say something? Are you going to say something?
No, it's chair.
We're left with two Spitfires. One Messerschmitt 109. And the Americans have just been shot down.
Right. One of your boys has just been shot down. Another brother!
When you have a White House like that, it's on your bloody ass. One thing you don't do, give up, throw it all away, not at all. Put it back in its pot. Oh, look at it. Oh, dear. And get out the glue.
You'll say
that air draft is terrible. Believe it or not. The radios we use to fly these models these days are incredibly reliable. There was a time not so long ago when if you've got a control flight, but by all sorts of models, gliders, scale, everything. And we have an awful lot of fun, as I'm sure you all read. Here comes the 109. I think he won that one. I think we're going to have to concede. Two split cars, one again, lost his engine. Losing height in a series of S turns onto the final. He wants to land it. Speed if he can. Here he comes. See, one's still got his engine running, he's going round. The man without the engine better land on the grass on this side of the runway. There he goes.
Is anybody super glue? Is anybody been yelling at super glue?
There you have it. You get us from the unconditional surrender. The unconditional surrender.
We shall never surrender.
Where's that brandy hat?
I like you.
We shall defend our islands, whatever the cause. We shall fight on the beaches. We shall fight on the land. We shall fight on the fields and in the air. We will never surrender. There's going to be yellow bit of paper.
Every new word is spelled.
Let me yellow bit of paper.
Just
yellow bit.
That's all. Just the blood,
not the death. Yeah. We are about now to witness the unconditional surrender of the German forces. First to sign will be General Dwight Eisenhower. Followed by Joseph Comrade Stalin. And then followed by
Monte.
Field Marshal Montgomery.
Thank you very much. As I said before, we said we will fight in France,
We shall fight on the beaches, we will fight on the sea and in the air. We shall fight with growing confidence and strength in air and in sea. We shall defend our islands, whatever the cost may be. We shall fight in beaches, landing grounds, in the hills, but we shall never surrender. Thank you. Could we have Mr. John Cathcart to witness these signatures?
John! Come on.
John!
An independent
witness, even though he does sell still sauce.
And the more you have, the stiller you get. What do you do now? Do you salute or not?
Yes, John Baggins.
Mr. Cathcart, we'll give it your pleasure now to take Air General Von William to the cells. Well, we give him a reprieve.
Reprieve.
We give him a reprieve.
Oh, no, 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 reprieve. Take him away.
There you are. There you go.
Full size team is powered by a single inimitable world on Burley Street. 1,030 great horsepower, 12 cylinders, all pocket away themselves, beautifully built into the enemy. Thanks. It was also made in America. Packard Motor Company produced a vast quantity. I'm told that they produce so many attractive bombs. Unfortunately, there's still a number of engines hanging around that will hopefully keep these very few hurricanes and a growing number actually at Spitfire flying. Arthur was telling me earlier that he wasn't going to do any sort of aerobatics with this aeroplane. But I think he's getting a bit handy with it. He is displaying it beautifully for me. Now he's really got trouble. gone down. They're coming back, they'll be looking for survivors through the smoke. Look at that.